EG4's new GridBOSS and FlexBOSS units are an awesome and much needed evolution in the solar space. But what exactly are these two units and why do you need them for your next project? So welcome back to the lab where our opinions cannot be bought. We talk about this GridBOSS FlexBOSS combo on the channel a lot, but we've never really taken the time to show you guys exactly what it is and how it works. As always, before we jump into it, we will leave links in the description down below to both the products and any discount codes we can get for you guys on those products. But before we jump into our experience using these and some of our favorite features about this combination, we're gonna quickly zip over the FlexBOSS and the GridBOSS individually so you guys know exactly what they are and why they exist. So to make this simple, the FlexBOSS is an inverter. We've made full-length videos on both the FlexBOSS 18 and the FlexBOSS 21 on the channel. And what makes them unique, aside from their impressive specs, is that they have the ability to start a 5-ton air conditioner without a sure starter. Straight out of the box, these guys have enough power to get it done. And they don't come with a 200-amp bypass built in, which basically means a traditional hybrid inverter was able to pass 200 amps of power directly through it, which kind of made it feel like an all-in-one solution. But the issue with that is that people who wanted the power of a big inverter like this, but they were using it off-grid or even just in a garage setup like we have right here where we're not actually tied into the grid, they were still paying for that 200 amp bypass to be included in the inverter even though they weren't using it. So basically they were overpaying for their inverters. The FlexBOSS not having the 200 amp bypass means that it's cheaper upfront for people who are trying to buy it from more of an off-grid setup and they don't actually need to pass grid power through it. But if you are using it in a hybrid setup and you do want to pass grid power through it, you just buy the GridBOSS, which comes with the 200 amp bypass and it costs you no extra money. And here's why. So when you're installing a hybrid system, you need it to pass code inspection if you plan to actually tie it to the grid. And traditionally to do this, you had to get a manual bypass and transfer switch as well as the wiring that's associated with that and wire it outside of your inverter, mount it on the wall or whatever to actually get it to pass code. And so the cost of those switches with the wiring, most installers weren't able to actually get that job done for any less than like $2,500. So EG4 recognized this, saw it as an opportunity, and designed the GridBOSS. The GridBOSS is a service entrance, or they call it an MID, which is a microgrid interconnected device. And so instead of going the traditional route of getting the wiring, the switches, and mounting them in the open on the wall beside your inverter, you can now just buy the GridBOSS, which comes with both of those switches built directly into it, and you just need a simple wire to go between your FlexBOSS and your GridBOSS. And not only does it look so much cleaner, but it comes with a ton of additional features, including the 200 amp bypass that the FlexBOSS is missing. And the cost of the GridBOSS right now is only $19.99, even less with our discount code. And so since you were already gonna need to spend that $2,000-ish anyways, if you were trying to legally install a hybrid system, this GridBOSS is an absolute no-brainer. On top of giving you the 200 amp bypass and the switches that you need for code, it has a few other features as well. It has three hybrid ports, meaning you can connect three EG4 inverters into one GridBOSS, whereas traditionally every time you wanted to add a hybrid inverter, you would need another set of switches and wires. So that would be an additional $2,000 per inverter, whereas this, you spend the $2,000 one time and you can put up to three inverters into it. It comes with four smart ports, which basically gives you the ability to shed loads, prioritizing where power goes to maximize efficiency. We'll get into that a little bit more later. It has a grid input, so it offers you a direct connection to utility power. It also has a generator input, so you can tie a generator directly into this unit and program it a ton of different ways. And so basically, you're paying the same or less as you already would have, and you get a ton of extra features. Right now, it's really hard to compete with a setup like this. So great job to Jimmy and the boys for innovating something useful. So now that you guys are up to speed on what these units do, here we have our fully assembled system with the FlexBOSS 21 and the GridBOSS. We will go over the full actual setup, wiring, how to install everything in a different video. But as you guys can see for today's example, this is a super clean setup. There is a lot of wiring involved, but if you look at how those wires are all tied together and the amount of wire you actually need even versus a traditional hybrid setup, it's all really simple and honestly pretty straightforward. And so for the sake of testing here at the lab, we had SmartPort 1 and 2 set up with 60 amp breakers on each. We didn't have a breaker on the grid input. That is an option and we didn't choose to use it given we already have a grid disconnect elsewhere. And we did have breakers for our generator input and our backup load setup. And so once you have everything set up and running, you can use either your phone or the computer to actually connect and monitor your system. The app is okay, it lets you monitor everything, but you can't update anything over the app. You need to use the computer to actually update anything. There's a lot more settings and stuff you can access with the computer as well. It also fits a YouTube video much better, so we prefer to use the computer. So that's what we're gonna be showing you guys a ton of screenshots of today. But either way, it's really important to have a monitoring setup with a system like this. This is a lot more complex than a traditional just single inverter system. So having a computer screen open makes it much easier to see what's actually going on, because sometimes even just standing here looking at it, it's not super clear what is functioning and to what degree. So if you just open up the computer, you can easily see the grid power passing through, you can see solar power passing through, and you can see both of them working together if you're in a situation where the solar isn't high enough to meet the demand of your loads and the grid power is also running to help supplement some of that power. And so it's definitely important, because while you could sit here and visually see things like the EV charger turning on and off, if the sun is out but your generator is also ripping and you have both smart ports functioning, sometimes it's nice to be able to open that up and just check what the wattage is of all these things and make sure that you can keep a nice eye on what's actually happening. It's slightly delayed, obviously, because it needs a minute to kind of communicate from the GridBOSS to the computer, but it's within like 30 seconds. So as long as you're sitting there watching, you get a pretty accurate update of what's actually going on. So by far, our favorite feature of the GridBOSS is the load shedding. You can use the smart ports to turn on or off additional appliances. It doesn't have to be just an appliance. You can use it to turn on or off something like the EV charger or a water heater. You can also have it wired to an entire sub panel, so you can control the entire wing of your house if you wanted to with a single smart port, which is really, really cool. So for example, we had our EV charger and our garage heater run into smart ports 1 and 2. We had it set to turn off the EV charger if the batteries were lower than 87% and turn off the heater if the batteries were lower than 85%. Obviously that's high, but it's just for demonstration purposes. And you can see if you're looking at the monitoring system super clearly that as we're using power and those batteries are being drained, as you cross both those thresholds of the 87 and the 85%, you can see both smart loads give out as you cross that threshold. And then to get them to turn back on, there actually is like a 5% variance. So if you have it turn off at 85%, you can't have it turn back on within 5% of that. So in our case, it would have been 90%. And they pretty much do this so that if you have varying solar coming in and out to charge your system and your batteries are teetering at 85%, you don't have your EV charger like clicking on, clicking off, clicking on, clicking off. It'll just wait until you're getting a nice constant charge. And even if it's gonna use more power than you have coming in, at least it'll have like a 5% runway type of deal. So we had ours set to turn back on at 90% and 92%. And similarly to how they turn off, you guys can see if you watch the monitoring app as we're getting power going back into the system. As we pass those thresholds, the smart ports turn back on, everything in the garage comes back to life and actually visually works, which is really cool. And like I said earlier, we did it with two separate appliances, but you could go ahead and do it with an entire sub panel. Like you could run your pool heater and all that kind of stuff like on a sub panel, and you could have all of that be tied into a smart port. Like it's really, really versatile what you can do with it. And for these, it doesn't matter if you're charging with solar or with a generator or with the grid, you can have them function the same way no matter what. And what's really cool is you can set each individual port to a different mode. So in our testing, we use state of charge basically the whole time. As the battery state of charge reaches 87%, it turns off. But there's also time of use settings. So you could have it set up so that your smart port 1 turns off at 85%. Smart port 2 is your EV charger, and it only functions between the hours of 8 p.m. and 8 a.m. So you could have all your smart ports functioning on different modes to make the system super customizable. Wow, so wowy. And the second thing that we think is pretty cool, it's also kind of tied to those smart ports, is that there is a grid always on feature. And basically the system is designed to prioritize using either solar or your batteries. The grid is meant to be like a backup if you need it, but there is settings within those smart ports. So if you really need to charge your car and you're not really getting any solar and your batteries are relatively low, you can choose to just pass power from the grid right through to that smart port to make sure that you can power whatever's on the other end of that, which is definitely a nice feature. So it doesn't mean that whatever you tie into those smart ports is like locked off on the settings you have. You can easily supplement power with it and keep it running if you absolutely need to. And the last thing that we really like before we get into two bonus features that we kind of found, the amount that you can customize the generator input. It's actually crazy what you can do with a generator with this system. Like a traditional system, you can use the generator to substitute the grid at any point if the grid goes down. If you have a generator with dry connects, it can communicate directly with the GridBOSS. The GridBOSS will say, hey, turn on the generator, we need power. You can set thresholds for all that kind of stuff, whether they're time of day or state of charge. And so the two main takeaways that we took from all these settings is that you could get a smaller generator than you would need traditionally. So if you were to just have a generator system at your house, you need a generator that is big enough to power all of the loads you might be running all at once. Whereas with a system like this, you only need a generator that's slightly bigger than your average load is gonna be. Or if you're running intermittent loads, something like a sump pump, for example, where it comes on and goes back off, you can get a generator that's smaller than your average loads. And while those loads aren't running, it will still be charging your batteries. If it's just a little bit bigger than your average loads, it'll be enough to supplement those average loads, but also put the extra into your batteries. And the second part of that is that you can use it to keep your smart ports on. You can set it to supplement power, similar to the grid always on setting, but with a generator instead, which again is cool because if you're in a power outage situation, you have limited battery reserves and you're not getting the best solar input, but you really need to charge your car. You set the EV charger on the smart port to use the generator to get its power, and you can pass that right through to your smart port, and you're not really gonna kill your batteries or ruin your system at your house, which is just like how you would expect it to work, but there is no real limitations that we can find with what you can do with a generator, which is just really nice. The only stipulation is that your rate of charge from the generator has to be higher than your loads. So if you only have a 5,000 watt generator, you can't have your car charger set to charge above 5,000 watts. Or you could simply have it set to prioritize battery charging, so it'll ignore your smart ports, won't even kick them back on until they hit their own thresholds, and it'll just focus on charging up those batteries. And there's two really cool things, honestly, I think that we found during our testing that we wanted to relay to you guys, because they're just little tiny hacks, but if you don't think about them, you might not know them. And the first one is gonna be, we found a way to get extra solar into the inverter. Now the FlexBOSS 21 and 18 are both rated for a lot of solar, but if you wanted to go above and beyond that and you have access to a power station, which a lot of people probably do, you could actually do what we did with our Delta Pro Ultra, where we were running an additional 5,000 watts of solar into the Delta Pro Ultra, and then we had our Delta Pro Ultra wired into the generator port. So when it was saying it was using generator power, it was actually just passing solar through the Delta Pro Ultra into the generator port and giving us a bonus 5,000 watts of solar, which is a really cool little hack. If you guys have the ability to do that, it works really well. If you already purchased a Delta Pro Ultra, for example, for home backup, you don't have to feel like you're wasting that system when you upgrade to something like this. You can still use it and have it functioning and tie it into your existing system. So you feel like you're at least still getting your money's worth out of that original purchase. And the other thing that we were thinking about as we were doing this was that a lot of older homes have less than 200 amp service. A traditional modern home has a 200 amp service from the grid outside. Older homes had 75 amps or 100 amps. So you're more limited to what you can actually run inside of that house before you start blowing like your main breaker to your house. But with a system like the GridBOSS, if you tied three FlexBOSS, even 18s into it, you would have accessible to you more power than your actual grid input to your home. So if you were looking for a way to get additional power into your home, traditionally, you would have to get someone to come out and maybe install a new transformer in front of your house. They'd have to run bigger wires into your house. They would have to give you a bigger panel inside of your house. It's a ton of work to upgrade service. But if you were to do a system like this, you would actually just be able to use this system to power more things and just throw in a sub panel with those extra loads. If you're already building something and you want to upgrade your service anyways, don't waste your money on that. Just get another inverter or something and you have access to a ton of extra power. So So at the end of the day, this is a system that is extremely hard to beat. It's really versatile. It really doesn't cost you any more money than what it would have done before, and you get so much extras with it. But like we said, we will cover the entire install process in another video. It is a very large, lengthy process. It's not too hard, it's just long. So make sure you guys are subscribed so you don't miss that when it comes. Make sure you guys check out the links in the description down below. We will leave a ton of helpful stuff for you guys down there. That is all we got for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.